Good afternoon, the Honorable Chairman, the Co-Chairman, and the Fellow Speaker. My name is Igede Agung Chandra. I am from Maintenance Department. Let me introduce my fellow author, Mr. Muhammad Yunus Komarul Huda from Operation Department, and Mr. Muhammad Kamal Wisyaldin from Technology Department of PT Pembangkitan Jawa Bali. In this precious occasion, we will present about our paper which entitled A Study of Reducing Waste Heat Ejected by Condenser Using Thermoelectric Heat Pump to Decrease Net Plant Heat Rate of Coal Fire Power Plant. The case study takes place in Paiton 1 and 2 Coal Fire Power Plant. The outline of our presentation consists of some important points. The first is we will show you the current situation about the energy balance of referred coal fire power plant. It can be used as a guidance for us to know the latest performance of the plant. Obviously, we found that our plant performance is not competitive enough compared with the others, which is shown by the value of net plant heat rate as a net energy performance indicator. So, we need to fix the situation with innovation. One of promising method is using thermoelectric heat pump to capture the waste heat rejected in condenser. But the next problem is we still don't know about the optimum number of the thermoelectric heat pump configuration to be applied and its effect on the heat rate. So it will be discussed and answered in this paper. As mentioned before, I will show you the current energy balance of referred coal fire power plant based on Paiton Unit 1 and 2 report on April 2019. We generate 33.12% of power output as net electrical output, and energy losses is up to 66%. It comes from thermal and electrical losses. From the 66% of energy losses, which contain waste heat from rejected by condenser, flue gas, and parasitic electrical load, the highest amount is in condenser, which up to 88%. It's such a great amount of waste energy and gives us opportunity to reduce it. Before we explain about what is the problem background, I will make you more familiar about the referred coal fire power plant. Paiton Coal Fire Power Plant Unit 1 and 2 is a subcritical thermal power plant which constructed at 1993 and the fully commercial operation date in 1994, owned by PT Pembangkitan Jawa Bali. It has designed to consume high coal quality rank with the calorific value is about 6,000 kilocalorie per kilogram. In order to can survive in Jawa Bali electrical supply system, we have to change, we have to grow the business, because there is a competition among coal fire power plant to get the maximum portion of load distributed from PLN, which determined by merit order. Merit order is the rank of coal fire power plant based on their production cost in terms of rupiah per kilowatt hour. There is also threat from the existing Fast Track Program 1 and independent power producer with higher thermal efficiency and newer technology, which encourage us to take some strategic decision. One of them is applying coal switching program. The coal consumption in Paiton Unit 1 and 2 switched from 5,200 to 4,500 kilocalorie per kilogram to increase the position in merit order. But there are some side effects of coal switching, such as increased coal flow, produce more carbon dioxide emission, and increased net plant heat rate. To fix this problem situation, especially for net plant heat rate, which also become our key performance indicator, we have to reduce it, and we choose reducing it through increasing final feed water temperature. There is an opportunity to increase the final feed water temperature by reduce the waste heat rejected from condenser and reusing it by thermoelectric heat pump. Thermoelectric heat pump module consists of negative and positive semiconductor, which usually arranged in square array. Thermoelectric heat pump utilizes the flow of an electric current through the module to produce a thermal gradient. But the next question is that feasible to install thermoelectric heat pump in existing plant that we have? From the energy balance, we know the parameters such as operating condition, the power input, electrical output, and the energy losses through condenser. According to the reference, it will be feasible if the COP of thermoelectric heat pump equal to exchange of efficiency cycle. While efficiency cycle defined as the comparison between output thermal energy and input thermal energy. And COP is the indicator that used to determine the performance of heat pump. We use the module which commercially available from European Thermodynamic Ltd. The thermoelectric module have to install inside the condenser because it placed next to the steam side of the condenser to ensure the maximum thermal conductivity. Thermoelectric heat pump will be installed in the 5 different way. First, 2, 3, 4, and 5 cascade stage to aim the optimum number of thermoelectric heat pump array. This configuration is shown as being sandwiched between the heat sink and the external piping through which the condensed water pass. As shown on the THP installation figure, the minimum beneficial value of condenser COP is 3.02. The feed water will be raised from 40 degrees Celsius at the outlet condenser to 59.81 degrees Celsius at the temperature system. A 23.09 megawatt sensible heat will be required for feed water flow rate of 289.01 kilograms per second. We will explain the analysis and result of two-stage thermoelectric heat pump array. First, some input parameters are water enter thermoelectric heat pump first stage at temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. The measurement thermal resistance of the heat exchanger is 0.07 Celsius per watt. Flow rate water is 0.0013 kilograms per second. The temperature of cold side of thermoelectric heat pump is 39 degrees Celsius. The stage 1 to achieve feed water temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. Temperature required on the heated side of the thermoelectric heat pump is 67.35 degrees Celsius, producing resultant energy 25.47 watt and COP 3.3. The stage 2 have the same process to achieve feed water temperature of 59.81 degrees Celsius. The result is total electrical power need 9 megawatt. Total thermal power gain is 23.79 megawatt. Total module need 378,526. And the performance result of the thermoelectric pump two stage array are thermal energy reduction rejected 14.79 megawatt, new fuel consumption become 98.01%, and new plant efficiency become 33.05%. As shown in the chart between COP and cascade state configuration, the optimum COP will obtain in the fourth stage configuration with 3.333 COP. In chart between plant efficiency and cascade stage configuration, the optimum new plant efficiency also obtained in the fourth stage configuration with 33.2 efficiency. Refer to operation manual book, the increase of 1.67 degrees Celsius, temperature of feed water will decrease net plant heat rate by 0.1%. So, net plant heat rate will reduce by 0.66% or 18.08 kilocalorie per kilowatt from 2739.3 to 2721.22 kilocalorie per kilowatt. The summary of this paper including 4 cascade stage is the optimum heat pump configuration. Net plant heat rate will be reduced by 0.66% or 18.08 kilocalorie per kilowatt from 2739.3 to 2721.22 kilocalorie per kilowatt. Plant efficiency will increase by 0.06% from 33.12% to 33.18%. Coal consumption will reduce by 1.99% from 235.225 ton per hour to 230.75 ton per hour. Carbon dioxide released to atmosphere will be reduced about 0.1034 ton of carbon dioxide. So we can conclude that thermoelectric heat pump technology is theoretically feasible enough to be applied in Python Unit 1 and 2. And in the future, thermoelectric heat pump will be a very profitable innovation because there is a great amount of heat rejected by condenser that potentially can be retained. Thank you for your attention. I wish you all a blessed day.